So let's continue with the discussion. Let me share my screen. Okay, so we are in that example that is shown in front of you. So I am telling that in support vector machine, which has a special capability of enlarging the feature space. Er age je marginal classifier gulo tumra dekhle, it may be a hard marginal classifier or soft marginal classifier. It doesn't have the capability of enlarging the feature space. Only support vector machine is a much more upgraded version of all such kind of maximal margin classifier, which has the capability of enlarging the feature space. Enlarging means you can convert a linear dimension feature space into a non-linear form. Non-linear form means from either quadratic form or cubic form or any other higher order polynomial functions form. Okay, so that's why this is an example of a quadratic equation. Only quadratic I have shown here. Okay, example of a quadratic equations along with the application of the soft margin classifier. So the main difference between soft margin classifier and SVM, I think you can differentiate it, distinguish it. This is a soft margin classifier. Okay, it is applicable for the linearly separable, and this is the hard margin. Sorry, support vector machine classifier, which is applicable for our nonlinear issues with the help of enlarging the feature space. Higher dimensions, okay, not dimension, for a higher order function, okay, like quadratic or cubic or any other higher order polynomial, right? So if this thing has been given to you, which is a non-linearly separable space, okay, so you can understood that thing. You cannot draw any straight line, a single straight line to differentiate these things. So hard margin classifier fails, okay, and soft margin classifier, we should avoid the use of soft margin classifier because of that erroneous term, that error probability is more in case of soft margin classifier. So that's why we have used an extended or more upgraded version of the soft margin classifier, that is a support vector machine classifier, which has a concept of kernels. Remember it, listen it very carefully. Kernels is a core functions of our SVM classifier, which can achieve, by the help of kernel, SVM can achieve enlarging the feature space quality. এই যে এনলার্জিং ফিচার স্পেস যেটা করতে পারছে, দ্যাট ইজ কল্ড আ কার্নেল ট্রিক। এই কার্নেল ট্রিক মেক্স ইট পসিবল টু অ্যাচিভ দ্য সিমিলার রেজাল্টস অ্যাজ ইফ ইউ হ্যাড অ্যাডেড মেনি পলিনোমিয়াল ফিচার্স, ইভেন উইথ ভেরি হাই ডিগ্রি পলিনোমিয়ালস উইদাউট অ্যাকচুয়ালি হ্যাভিং টু অ্যাড দেম। ওকে, সো দিস ইজ ইয়োর লিনিয়ার নন লিনিয়ার সেপারেবল স্পেস, অ্যান্ড ইফ আই উইল বেন্ড that space from one dimension to the quadratic dimension, okay, not dimension, from single linearly non-linearly separable space to a quadratic space. So it will look like this. We actually folding it. Okay, we actually folding the entire dimension. So it will look like this. So if you fold it, if you fold this paper in a two dimension, okay, then this will be coming down, and this will be coming, these two circles will, four circles will be coming up. Now you are eligible to draw a straight line, a Decision boundary to separate these two classes. And that is called a quadratic x1 square. এরকম করে যদি কোয়াড্রেটিক দিয়ে তুমি ফেলিওর হও, ওকে, দেন ইউ উইল গো ফর দ্য কিউবিক। ইফ ইউ উইল ফেল ফর দ্য কিউবিক, দেন ইউ উইল গো ফর দ্য আদার হায়ার অর্ডার পলিনোমিয়ালস, ওকে, লাইক কোয়াড্রেটিক অর সাম আদার্স, লাইক কোয়াটারনারি পলিনোমিয়ালস, ফর আদার পেন্টাগোনিয়াল পলিনোমিয়ালস, ইউ ক্যান গো ফর দোজ কাইন্ড অফ পলিনোমিয়ালস, ওকে। Actually, in kernels, in SVM kernels, there are various kind of kernels are available. Mostly the most popular use of kernels, jar modhe mota moti real world problem gulo satisfy kore jay. And those kernels are, these are the kernel expressions I have given to you. Okay, various kind of kernels. So this is the general linear support vector classifier will look like this. Okay, the functions of the linear vector classifier will look like this. Okay, when we will apply the kernel trick, okay, for this classifier to improve the call non-linear separable quality, okay, of the with the help of the kernel function we use, we could replace every instance of this one summation of this one, okay, that is x and xi prime. So we could replace it. This is a linearly separable class, so we can replace it with the help of some kernel function or some quadratic function. So 1 plus summation j equal to 1 to m xij comma xij bar, these are the two points, and to the power d means the dimension. So that when d becomes 2, it will work like a quadratic. When d becomes 3, it will work like a cubic. When d becomes 4, it will work like a much more higher order polynomial. Okay. So in this case, in this as a d is called a degree of polynomial. That I already discussed, the degree of polynomial. And d should be greater than 1. Obviously, d equal to 1, hole to amader ei function nawa dorkar nei, then a soft margin classifier will be enough for it. But if we'll make d equal to greater than 1, d greater than 1, that means we will go for the higher order degree polynomial. Okay. And when d is greater than 1, the first kind of radial kernel has been discussed here, has been expressed here. That is called radial kernel. Okay. First kind of kernel is radial kernel. So radial kernel is the first kind of kernel, and it will look like this. Exponential of minus gamma summation j equal to 1 to m xij minus xi prime j whole square of this. Okay. So this gamma is called a positive constant. I already told there are two hyperparameters that we need to use to tune our model, SVM model. One is gamma, another one is cost, the C function that I already discussed in the previous case. This is the cost of C function, this one, C, okay, this one, the cost function or C function. So these are the two hyperparameters that we should take care of it if we want to tune our model. When I our model ke tune kore, if I want to improve the accuracy of our model, then you can go for these two kind of hyperparameters. When the value of gamma is high, then it considers only the nearby points or objects, and when the gamma is low, or far away points are also considered. Okay. He bolche gamma value ta jokon high hobe, if the gamma value is high, gamma is a positive constant, if the gamma value is high, then it considers only the nearest points or nearest objects or nearest observations. And when the gamma value is low, then it also consider not only nearest point as well as for the far away point. Okay. So so it is preferable that the gamma value should be low. It is preferable. Okay. Now, this is a radial kernel, and these are the degree kernels or polynomial degree kernels. Okay. So these are the various kind of kernels that we can use. Okay. So shall I go for the code? If you check the code. Let me show you the code for the SVM. I'm not going to show the other things. The rest of the things I already discussed. You can take one data set. You will have to divide the data sets into a training set and testing set, either with 70:30 ratio or 80:20 ratio, that I already discussed, okay, in my previous coding examples. Now, this is the function that we are using for SVM test, okay, support vector machine test. Now, SVC, we will use, this is the name of the function, which is called support vector classifier, SVC. It is a part of that sklearn package. It is a part of sklearn package. Take it now. Okay. sklearn.a.svm package. It is a part of that SVC. Now, at the first end, we have to apply the model.append. We have to apply this SVM function with the help of SVC. Okay. So we will check how I have written the SVC. SVC, then gamma parameter auto. We will make it automatic. That means whatever the system or the SVC function will automatically give, we will go for that gamma parameters till we are not tuning our model. Okay. Now kernel. What is the kernel? We will choose the poly kernel. Poly means polynomial kernel. We will choose. Okay. Polynomial kernel, we will choose. The kernel can be a linear kernel. Linear kernel is equivalent to that soft margin classifier. When the kernel becomes non-linear, that means polynomial or cubic or radial, then it becomes a support vector classifier. Okay. So it's your choice. Okay, linear kernel, then we choose korte paro. Then it depends whether in case of linear kernel, it will give up good results or not. Okay, so kernel equal to poly. We will choose poly means polynomial kernel. Or you can also write radial there. For the radial kernel, choose. And you have to check whether your testing data set, this function, this 5 lines for testing the data sets on this trained model SVC. So we have fitted the SVC model on for X and Y data. We have these two data that I have already divided in terms of the data set which we have taken as an input. And here we will use the gamma as automatic gamma and kernel as a polykernel, means polynomial kernel. And then we will apply the predict function for the validation X. Validation X means you're testing data set. 20% rekhe diyecho, but 30% rekhe diyecho. 70:30 or 80:20. 80 is used for the training purpose and 20 is for testing purpose, that 20% data in your input data set has been stored in X validation. Okay, সেটা আশা করি মনে আছে তোমাদের, আমি আগে দেখিয়েছিলাম তোমাদের নেইভ বায়াস আর KNN এর ক্ষেত্রে দেখিয়েছিলাম কিভাবে সেটাকে স্টোর করবো. ওকে, আই থিঙ্ক ইউ ক্যান, ইউ আর রিমেম্বারিং দ্যাট থিং. So this X validation is your testing data. And based on that, now we will calculate the accuracy score of the Y validation and prediction, whatever you have predicted and whatever the Y validation. Y validation means the given data. What is the given prediction has been given to you. That means the confusion matrix. If you remember the confusion matrix, it is nothing but a 2+2 matrix for our actual data and the predicted data. Actual data has been already presented in your input data sets. If we divide into 80s to 20, so that 20 data sets also presented with the actual data, actual Y value, and we are not considering here because for the testing purpose we will omit that Y value consideration. Okay, we'll only go for the X values, and for X values what predictions your model will give, then at final stage we'll compare what value has been given to you in the data sets or mentioned in the existing data sets and what value you have predicted, and based on that you can calculate the confusion matrix or accuracy score, and then you can generate your classification report. Okay, is it clear to you? Bujhte parle? Is this code clear to you? Prottek bujhte parle?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
So here I actually did a training. A line tadi train kochi model take. I have actually performed a training in this line, and here I am doing the testing. In this four line, I am doing the testing. Fit the model on the training data set and then do the testing or validation checking. This is the R code. Jara R jano ba jante chaicho. This is the R code for you. Okay, that classifier I have actually applied for an iris data set. I already discussed about the general structure of the iris data set. If you remember, it consists of four features and one class levels. Okay, and total 150 instances are there. Means 150 rows or tuples are there in iris data set. So what are those four features? The features go likhe rakhechi ekhane. Petal dot width, petal dot length, sepal dot width and sepal dot length. Okay, these are the four features. Sepal dot width and sepal dot length. Petal, sepal, iris actually a flower name. A very famous flower in USA. And within that flower, there is petal and sepal, the different components of the flowers are there. And then the length and width of that petal and sepal. And its species is the class, the dependent variable or the class level variable, species. One of those species, three species are there. Versicolor, setosa, versicolor, and another species, I just forget. Three species are there. So if we apply our SVM in case of R, this is the iris data sets. Okay, I run my code for the iris data sets. So sepal dot length, sepal dot width, petal dot length, petal dot width. These are the four features or independent variable. That means your x1, x2, x3, x4, and this species is your Y variable. Okay, which has different classes. Tinte level ache, mane tinte class ache. Okay, setosa, versicolor, and a virginica. Tinte ache. Setosa, versicolor, and virginica. Okay, now we will continue. ggplot is such kind of library in R which we are using for doing any kind of plotting operation. Okay, this is a plotting operation. This is the iris data sets. We will see here tinte class ache, that's why three colors has been shown: red color, green color, and blue color. Red color is represent the setosa class, green color is represent the versicolor class, and blue color will represent the virginica class. Okay, this is the initial data sets, and petal width and petal length er moddhe ei combination ta poreche, petal width, petal length. Okay, so you can draw the graph for the sepal width and sepal length. Just change it, petal length with sepal length and petal width with sepal width. Okay, you can draw the same graph. Okay, now e1071, this is a such kind of library present. E1071 present, or you can say this is a such kind of package present in R, where all the machine learning functions or data mining functions are inbuilt or system built. Jekom okane sklearn python er khetre sklearn, in case of R it is e1071. Echar arekta package o ache, that is also very used or you can say most popular package, which is called library caret. Okay, this caret package has also a extensive use. in our family, okay, for the machine learning or data mining kind of task. And E1071 is also a very popular package. Okay, I'm using here E1071. Now we will apply the SVM classification on our model. My model is the key store. Ache. My model is actually a variable. We will apply the SVM on our data set Irish. Okay, and species is the target variable that we have to write. And kernel may be polynomial, but I am not mentioning any explicit kernel here. That's why by default it will take radial. Okay. By default, it will take radial. Okay. Sigmoidal kernel is also there. Sigmoidal. Ethogulo kernel is radial, sigmoidal, and polynomial. Polynomial and radial I have already shown to you. Okay. So I am going to apply SVM here. Apply successfully. Now, summary of my model. This is the summary of my model. After applying SVM, this is the summary of my model. Okay, SVM type, SVM kernel that I have applied here, that is radial. I have already told by default is radial. So radial it will take. In case of R programming language, by default is radial. Okay, so this is a cost parameter 1 and this is a gamma parameter 0.25. That has been also given by default. Okay, you can tune these parameters. Okay, in next line, I will show you how you can tune it. And this plot. Plot means now I'm plotting after these things, I'm plotting my data set. So this is the SVM classification report. Okay, these are SVM classification report. This pink color line will represent the Virginica class. This white color subspace will represent the Varsi color. And this blue color subspace will represent the Setosa classes. Okay, SVM classification plot. Now this is the tuning helps to select the base model. Okay, now this tuning can tune the SVM model. Okay, can tune the SVM model. So there is a tune function we will call, SVM we will call, and species, data iris, rest of the things are same. Only these things is a new one that will be part as a parameter of the tuning model. Okay, so we will change it. We will change the cost function. Look how we can change the cost function. In this way, we can change the cost function. Okay, in case of our R. And then after tuning the model, we'll plot our model. Okay, and then summary of that tuning model. This is a summary of the tuning model. Okay, this is the epsilon value, this is the cost, this is the error, and this is the dispersion. After summary, then we will fit the model with our base model and then we'll further classify it. Now we will do the prediction. In this way, we'll do the prediction. Prediction means your model will be tested with the predicted value. That means the validation phase. Okay, this is a validation phase. Now, we will represent our confusion matrix here. Look, this is a confusion matrix. Okay, in last class, I already showed the confusion matrix in such a way. If you remember, this is a confusion matrix. So these are actual values, actual data there according to x-axis, and predicted data there according to y-axis. So actual data is 50. Predicted data for the Setosa class, actual data is 50, and predicted data is also 50. So there is no error in case of Setosa class. Achha, in case of Varsi, in case of Virginica class and Varsi color class, so you can say that Virginica class, this is a misclassification. Some misclassification are there because total 50 Varsi color are there, only 48 it can be predicted correctly, and 2 has been mispredicted as Virginica, but it should be Varsi color. Clear? Bujhte parle? Total 50 should be there. If 50 asto, then it's 100% accuracy. But it has come as 50 and this one 50, but this one is 48. That means this 2 is actually a misclassification results. Okay, so now from here you can calculate the accuracy. Okay, so I can calculate the accuracy here, and the misclassification results, these are 1 minus misclassification. The misclassification error is 0.01333. This is a misclassification error. Okay, so from here you can also calculate the accuracy. I didn't show the accuracy here. I didn't calculate the accuracy here, but from here you can also calculate, because you have the confusion metric. So here you can calculate the accuracy as well. Okay, but I'm going to accuracy calculate kore tomader dekhai ni. Right, is it clear? Bujhte parle? Those who are using R model, they can use this thing. R is much more lighter software and it is well suited for the statistical purpose and for the machine learning or data mining kind of purposes. Okay, but for the other cases, Python is very good. Python is very good for lots of applications, like for computer vision, for other, apart from statistical or method machine learning, it has a huge application, Python. But R is the only suitable for mathematical, statistical, or machine learning kind of purpose. Okay? Is it clear to everyone? Bujhte parle? This is all about SVM.
Sir, give us some break, sir.
Break. Acha. Break dichi. I just ekta jinis bole dichi tomader. এটা বাড়িতে একটু তোমরা দেখবে যে হাউ এসভিএম উইল বি অ্যাপ্লিকেবল ফর মাল্টি ক্লাস ক্লাসিফিকেশন। এখনো পর্যন্ত তোমাদের যেটা দেখিয়েছি অল আর বাইনারি ক্লাস ক্লাসিফিকেশন মোস্টলি। ওকে, হাউ ইট উইল বি অ্যাপ্লিকেবল ফর মাল্টি ক্লাস ক্লাসিফিকেশন। তো দেয়ার আর টু কাইন্ডস অফ টেকনিক্স দ্যাট উইল বি অ্যাপ্লিকেবল ফর মাল্টি ক্লাস ক্লাসিফিকেশন। ওয়ান ইজ ওয়ান ভার্সেস ওয়ান এসভিএম ক্লাসিফিকেশন, অ্যান্ডার ওয়ান ইজ অল ভার্সেস ওয়ান এসভিএম ক্লাসিফিকেশন। দিজ আর দ্য টু টেকনিক্স দ্যাট উই আর গোয়িং টু অ্যাপ্লাই ফর মাল্টি ক্লাস ক্লাসিফিকেশন এসভিএম। জাস্ট ওভারঅল একটু বলা আছে, আই থিঙ্ক ইফ ইউ check it out and you will understand that thing. I think so. And the pros and cons, SVM works well when the user has no idea about the data. It works well for unstructured data. Okay, good structured data. Dorkar nei SVM e khetre. Kernel trick is a real strength of SVM. Any complex problem or non-separable data issues can be solved with the help of the kernel trick that I already discussed. Cons means the disadvantages. Choosing a suitable kernel is challenging job. Ekkhuni ami bollam. So which kernel you should choose? Radial, polynomial, sigmoidal, that you will have to apply and check the accuracy of your model, okay, each and every time. For which kernel your accuracy will get the best accuracy, you will go for that kernel or you will choose that kernel. So it's a challenging job to choose a kernel, okay. Second disadvantage, SVM requires long training time for large data sets. If the data set is very, very large, then SVM training time is long, okay. It's second disadvantage of SVM. And last one is, it is not easy to fine tune the hyperparameter like cost and gamma using in SVM. Okay, cost and gamma take joto ami tune kori, but it is a trial and error. You can understood, I am changing the values of cost and gamma in as a trial and error basis. So it is a difficult to tune the cost and gamma parameters while we are tuning the SVM model. Okay, so these are the advantages and disadvantages of SVM classification. Okay, and parite tumra obosshoi eta porbe. Okay, in campus interview sometimes they will ask what are the basic approaches by which we can apply SVM for multi-class classifications. Okay, SVM is mainly suitable for binary class, but what are the approaches that for which we can apply SVM for multi-class classification? These are the two approaches, one versus one SVM, another one is all versus one. If you don't understand, please tell me in the next class or ask me in the next class. Okay, clear? Everyone clear?
Yes, sir.
Now I am giving you a 5 to 10 minutes break. Okay, I'm calling the roll numbers, and after calling the roll numbers, all of you join into the next link. Okay, then I will show some of your codes of computer vision that will be very interesting for you, and then I will go for the next topic, that is clustering. So this classification can be done in other ways, like classification we can do classification with the help of artificial neural network, deep learning neural network. But right now I am not focusing on this. Okay, I'm not discussing about this. Okay, in future you can apply classification for neural network with help of neural network and deep neural network. Okay. Okay. I'm just calling the roll number. It will be responded.